Hello and welcome to my channel. This is Vivek. Today in this video, we are going to discuss about the difference between a measurement current transformer and protection current transformer. As you all know, current transformer is one of the very important instruments when it comes to measurement of huge ampere of current passing through a transmission line, or if it is for protection purpose, a current transformer has a great role to play. It is an important instrument used in substations or power stations itself. So today in this video, we will discuss in detail about the differences between the measurement current transformer and protection current transformer, and we'll see that why they cannot be used interchangeably. Let's get started. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and do hit the bell icon notification button. So today in this video, what we are going to discuss, these are the 5 points that I have made. So here we will discuss about the operation of measurement current transformer. Then I'll talk about the operation of protection current transformer. We will briefly see both of them. Then we'll see the design aspects of the measurement and protection CTs. It is important to understand that how they are designed so that they cannot be used interchangeably. So there is a difference between the design of the both. And then I will come to what happens if we interchange both of them. And then I will finally conclude this video. So first of all, we come to a measurement current transformer. As you can see on the right hand side, this is the picture of a measurement current transformer. Simply speaking, what does a current transformer do? So let's say if I have a line over here which is carrying 100 ampere of current. Okay, now I have a ammeter which has a range of around 5 amperes or maximum of 10 amperes. But if I consider it is a 5 ampere ammeter, so how I will be able to measure the current passing through this line? So there the role of a measurement current transformer comes. What I will do is that I will connect a primary coil of the current transformer over here. Okay, it's not actually so much of turns, so there are just like one turn or something like that, and the secondary of the current transformer, the secondary coil that is there, I will collect the output from there and I will connect it to the ammeter. So basically, just like a transformer, what does a transformer do? If I talk about a step down transformer, a simple transformer, not a current transformer. So a step down transformer, basically, let's say if I have a 2:1 transformer. So if I have 220 volt and 5 ampere of current flowing through the line, the transformer will convert it to 110 volt. That is, it will halve the voltage and it will double the current. Why does this happen is that the product of the voltage and current gives us the power, and in a transformer the overall power on both the side remains constant. Similarly, here what happens in the case of a current transformer, you can compare it with a step up transformer. So on the other side we have a higher voltage but we have a lower current. Okay, so 100 ampere is converted into 5 ampere, and now we can connect it to the ammeter that we have and it will show us 5 ampere, and therefore we will understand that the actual current that is there, it is 20 times what I am seeing on the meter. If my meter is showing 4 ampere, so that means the actual current in the line is 80 ampere. Okay, because 100 ampere is shown by 5 ampere, so 20 times. Okay, so this is the basic use of the measurement current transformer. Now let us come to the protection current transformer. Protection current transformer has entirely a different role to play. It is different from measurement current transformer. So this is how a protection current transformer looks like. Now basically it is used to actuate a relay, okay, which will turn on the circuit breaker. Now understand what happens. Let's say this line is connected. This is a line of, let's say, carrying out 100 amperes of current. Okay, and 100 ampere of current is flowing. Suddenly some fault happens, let's say line to ground fault, line to line fault, different kind of faults are there. And what is the basic feature of a fault? The line current increases 10 to 20 times. That's very normal that during a fault, what happens? The current within the line increases from normal to 10 to 20 times. At that time, what happens? It is important that this line is disconnected so that this fault can be countered. Okay, so this line need to be disconnected, and this is done by a circuit breaker. But it is not only done by the circuit breaker. What happens is that, let's say suddenly the current goes from 100 ampere to 10 times, let's say 1000 ampere because of some fault. So this current transformer over here, that will also take this 10 times of the current. The primary will take up this 10 times of the current, and it will send the equivalent current to the secondary. So the secondary current will also increase by 10 times. Let's say it was saying showing us 5 ampere, and suddenly the 10 times, that is 50 ampere of current is flowing through the secondary. Because of that, what will happen? This, what you are seeing, is a relay. Okay, so this relay spindle that is there, this will be attracted because this coil, the secondary coil of the current transformer, is energized because of the 50 amperes of current, and it will attract the relay switch down. As the relay switch will be attracted, it will complete the connection of this circuit breaker. This is the circuit breaker. So the circuit breaker will be completed, and because of that, this circuit breaker contact that is there, it will be attracted by the circuit breaker coil, and hence it will open up, thus it will discontinue the flow of the current, that is the fault current. So this is how this entire operation happens. Important point to note is that, now you may ask that in normal situation 5 ampere of current is flowing through the secondary of the protection CT, so why doesn't the relay coil that is there, why doesn't this relay spindle that is there, it is not attracted? This is because it has been connected with a spring, right? The relay is connected in such a manner that only if the fault current is there, if the secondary is feeling 50 amperes of current, then only this will be attracted. Because the secondary coil can then only generate the enormous amount of force required for attracting the spindle of the relay. Okay, so that is very much important to understand. Under normal operation, the force generated by this coil is not enough to attract the relay contact. Okay, so this is the work of a protection current transformer. Now let us come to the design aspect of the measurement current transformer and protection current transformer. Now let me draw plot between the excitation current, let's say I excitation, I am showing it like this, and the open circuit voltage. You can call it open circuit voltage, or you can call it the maximum magnetic field flux that is being generated, because we know for a coil that V equal to 4.44 phi MFN, we know this relation. So the induced voltage is directly proportional to the maximum magnetic field flux. But for now, I am taking it just like the induced voltage. Okay, so if I have a coil and I am supplying it by some power source, so I will see that how much will be the induced voltage, or how much will be the maximum magnetic field flux generated in within the coil. So initially, during when the excitation current is given, let's say it begins to rise like this. Okay, it begins to rise like this, and then with the increase in the excitation current, the open circuit voltage is also increasing, and suddenly it goes something like this, and after a while it turns out to be like this. So this is how the curve is shown. What does this mean? Now what is the meaning of this curve? With the increase in the excitation current, we can see initially what is happening, that the open circuit voltage is also increasing. Okay, here we can see that it is increasing. And at a certain point of time, if the excitation current is increased to a certain level, what will happen? That the coil will not be able to induce more voltage. Okay, so it will saturate. What does this mean is that the coil will not be able to generate more magnetic flux corresponding to the extra amount of the excitation current that we are giving. And it will just basically saturate. At this position, what will happen? It will just behave like a normal resistor, and it may burn out because of this huge amount of current. Okay, so it will not be able to generate that much amount of magnetic field flux corresponding to the current. So it will increase initially, but at a certain point of time, it will just saturate. So this is how the coil reacts. Now there are two important points over here. This point that you are seeing, this is called the ankle point. Okay, this is called ankle point. And this over here, you can say this one, from where the saturation begins, this is called the knee point. Okay, knee point. So beyond knee point, if the excitation current is increased, the coil will not generate any extra amount of magnetic field flux, no further induced EMF. Okay, so that is important. Here also you can see in this picture, you will understand this quite clearly that here you can see this is the ankle point. Okay. And this is called the linear region, this one. Okay. In this region, what happens? The voltage, the induced voltage increases direct or it is directly proportional to the excitation current. But after knee point, what happens? It enters into saturation region. And in this region, any increase in the excitation current doesn't affect the maximum magnetic field flux generated by the coil or the voltage or the induced voltage within the coil. So that is an important point. Now, what is the relation between this curve and the difference between the measurement CT and the protection CT? Well, the point is that the measurement CT is made to operate at the knee point, whereas the protection CT is made to operate near the ankle point, and that is the basic difference between both of them. Why they are made like that, let us understand. See, near the knee point, what we can see that any increase in the current, any increase in the excitation current will not lead to further magnetization of the coil. Okay. Now, for a measurement CT, what is important? One of the major important factor, or I can say it is the only important factor about a measurement CT, that it should be able to accurately measure the current that is being supplied. Okay, so it should not be a lossy machine. It should not be, consuming itself a huge amount of power. It should not make the current go low or high. It should measure the accurately. Like if I am connecting a 100x5 current transformer, so if 100 ampere of current is flowing, then my meter should show 5 ampere, or there might be a certain amount of tolerance will be there in my data, but it should not reflect. Like if I have 100 ampere flowing and my CT is showing me 4 ampere, that's a huge amount of error that is there. So the important point about a measurement current transformer is that it should give the real data. For that, it is very much important that the current transformer used for the measurement is not attracting itself a huge amount of current. Now, if it is operating at the knee point, so that means if the current flowing through it begins, okay, so it will automatically be pushed into the saturation region, which means the current transformer for the measurement will not be able to magnetize its coils. Okay, what is the effect of it? If the coil is magnetized itself, if the current is flowing through the current transformer and the coil of the current transformer is itself getting magnetized, so it will generate a huge amount of magnetic field flux. This magnetic field flux, as we know by the Lenz law, will try to stop the current flowing through it. As we know, the effect opposes the cause, as the Lenz law says. So it will try to push the current in the backward direction, and because of that, what will happen? The reading that we will get will be incorrect. That's why the current transformer for measurement is made to operate near the knee point, so that it is automatically be pushed into this saturation region once it is connected, right? It should be pushed into this saturation region. Okay, so it will not be able to generate that much amount of magnetic field flux, and it will just take a little bit of current from the supply, and it will generate a little bit of magnetic field flux, but most of the current will be transferred on the other side, and we will be able to measure it on the ammeter. On the other hand, protection CT, what is the working principle of protection CT, or not working principle, I would say that what is the priority of protection CT? So the priority of the protection CT is, number one, it should be able to take 10 to 20 times of the current flowing through the line, because during the fault situation, 10 to 20 times is very normal. This much amount of current will be flowing through the line, and the current transformer connected for the protection should be able to take that current. Now, second important thing is that it should be able to actuate the relay at the correct point of time. Here you can see it should be able to actuate this relay, because if it is not able to actuate this relay, the whole point of this current transformer, this relay and the circuit breaker, everything remains of no use, right? So it should be able to do that. Now, why this protection current transformer is made to operate near the ankle point? Because as I said that the current transformer has to take 10 to 20 times of the full load current that is flowing through the line during the time of fault. So now if only it is operating near the ankle point, what will happen? let's say there is a fault. So 10 to 20 times of the full load current will be flowing through the line, and therefore the transformer operating region will be pushed into this linear region. Okay, why it is important? Because this has not only to take 10 to 20 times of the current, but it has also to reflect it on the other side, that is secondary side. Because the secondary side, only if the current goes from 5 to 50 ampere or 100 ampere, something like that, then only it will be able to actuate the relay. Then only it will be able to generate the magnetic field flux necessary for attracting the spindle of the relay. So that's why it has to generate the magnetic field flux. And now if it is made to operate near this knee point, then automatically it will be pushed into the saturation region. It will not be able to generate magnetic field flux. Rather, what will happen? The coil will burn away. And if it is not able to generate magnetic field flux, then what will happen? It will not be able to attract the relay contact, and therefore the circuit breaker will not operate. Therefore, the entire system will be pushed into a catastrophic situation. Okay, so that is very much important to understand, that why the current transformer for measurement is made to operate near the knee point, whereas the protection CT is made to operate near the ankle point. Okay, so I hope you have understand that what happens if both are interchanged. Now, we can understand that if measurement CT is used for protection purpose, so what will happen? It will be pushed into saturation during fault current, and therefore it will burn away. Even if it doesn't burn away, then it will not be able to generate the required amount of force for the relay switch to operate. If I talk about the protection CT, if it is made to use for measurement, if it is taken for measurement purpose, so what will happen? First of all, it is costlier than measurement CT. Protection CT is costlier than the measurement CT. Okay, so first of all, we will be using the protection CT for a purpose where such a sophisticated system or such a costly device is not required. Okay, so it is itself a disadvantage. Second thing is that if the protection CT is used for measurement purpose, as I said, it is operating near the ankle point, which means any current which is passing through it will generate a huge amount of magnetic field flux within the coil of the current transformer itself. Okay, because if it is at the ankle point, any flow of current will push it into the linear region. And in the linear region, what does it means is that with the increase in excitation current, the magnetic field flux increases, the voltage increases. As it will be attracting huge amount of current and generating maximum magnetic field flux, therefore what will happen, it will, first of all, the magnetic field flux according to the Lenz law will push the current. It will try to decrease the current flowing through it, and therefore the measurement that we will be getting will be a faulty one. Second to that is this huge amount of magnetic field flux that is being generated, there will be some leakage flux out of that, and that may affect the ammeter that we are using as well as the circuit that we have. Okay, there will be a huge amount of stray losses. Okay, so that's why we don't use a measurement CT for protection purpose or a protection CT for measurement purpose. So I hope in this video I was able to make you clear about the difference between the two. If you have any suggestion, any feedback, any query, any question, you can put them in the comment section below. I will be happy to help you with that. Share this video with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and do hit the bell icon notification button so that you can receive the notification of every single video that I'm making. So thank you very much. This is Vivek Choubey, and I'll see you next time.